Hey folks, you're gonna like this one. We're jumping ahead about a month or so from the current videos, but I had some help and we had a great day, so we decided to take this thing to the next level. Check it out, you're gonna like it.
All right.
Do you want to The other thing we're gonna have to do is pull the rags out of the exhaust.
I already did that.
I'm thinking ahead of you.
Somebody got it.
The rags are just on the ground underneath the car.
Yeah, I would throw them off to the side. Okay. Is that oil soaked? For a reason.
Nothing up the lower radiator hose.
Nothing dripping out of the water pump.
Yeah, I've never had water in this motor.
Yeah.
Do you want to put the battery terminal on the battery?
Yep.
Just the negative one there, I think.
Yeah, just the negative.
That's a lot of water.
Or just the positive, I should say.
Yeah.
Negative is not too hard on the frame.
Oil comes out the dipstick.
Yeah.
Hopefully we didn't just fill up the oil pan.
You can check it quick.
Yeah. I'm hoping that means this has got an O-ring on it. I'm hoping that means that that's sealed. All right, next is gasoline. Do you want to pop the air cleaner off? Because we might have to spray some stuff in there.
I don't know if you bump it over.
Well, yeah, I will to get oil pressure, and then, but the real concern is, we'll see if that is enough to get fuel to the pump. Yep. We need it.
Yeah. Well, that and it might encourage some stuff to go up the line.
Right. Good. All right, first time fuel in the cell.
It's an 8-gallon tank, right?
Yeah.
C10, right? This is 93 octane. That was probably about 2.5 gallons. Should be enough to pick up with the pump.
Yeah.
I I'm gonna go. If you can hook it up to the positive side of the solenoid. The main battery.
Yeah, this side.
Yep. And then that can go to even this.
Yeah.
Electricity's off, so that's not gonna work.
Right. Alright, so let's keep that off of the header.
Ignition off is down, correct?
Correct. All right, so why don't you jump in the seat? That way you got quick access
eyes
to...
eyes on the gauge.
Yep.
In neutral. All
right, let's whip it over and see if it gets oil pressure and fuel.
Ready?
Yep.
Yep. All right, it came up. Let's see if we got anything happening up here.
15, leaf back down a little bit.
Keep going. Keep with the ignition off.
Yep, ignition off.
That's a 30 PSI just on the starter. That's good news.
That is good news.
Let's see if we got it.
Yeah, third drive.
Yeah. All right, go ahead and kick the ignition on. We'll see if...
ignition is on.
Go ahead.
Clear.
You can shut it off just for a minute.
Yep.
Off. You said the oil pressure was decent?
40 PSI at that, right, what, 2,000 RPM?
I have no idea what the history is on this carburetor, but...
seems like it's got a flat spot in it for sure.
Yeah. Can you keep it running with the...
I might be able to.
So go ahead.
Alright, ignition on. Clear?
Yep.
Clear?
Yep.
Okay. fairly warm, so it's, we're getting water in the thing.
Nice. You want to check the water level? I got ignition off right now.
Yeah, I don't know if there's any pressure or not.
I think the water level is good.
Okay.
It's expanding because it heated up. But.
Yeah. A little bit.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's expanding because it
heated up.
Yeah.
So I don't know why the
carburetor's not behaving, but it's just junk is really what it is.
Yeah.
let me grab a
healthy.
Yeah, is it still maintaining oil pressure?
Yeah, that it's holding at 40 below 40 PSI when it was, you know, that sweet spot where it likes to run.
Yep.
You know, that 2,000-2,500 RPM range.
Yep.
Which is what that's what it sounds like it's running at.
Yeah. I think the idle screw is backed all the way off. But.
But yeah, I was hoping good oil pressure. You know, like consistent. It's not like it's.
Yeah.
You know, you hold it at one spot and then it slowly creeps down.
Okay.
It was
all right, let's try it again. And I just got to double check the timing because I moved it to see if that would straighten the carburetor problem out.
Yep. All right, ready?
Yep. You get it. See if it'll idle. That's all vacuum leak or what?
Yeah. Yeah, because that's.
Is there any water temperature now?
Yes.
Okay.
We're getting temperature now. The gauge starts at 120, so
right.
We're not going to get anything until then. Yeah. But yeah, just creeped off of 120.
Yeah, that's about right. Go ahead and start it up again.
All right, I'll keep it running.
It up.
in power in 55 years. Just keep the brake on with the clutch out.
Start it up again.
Yep. Start.
Hold it to the floor.
Put it in second gear.
Turn around, see if it fires up again. Thank you.
fires up again.
So there might be something going on with that distributor. All right, that's the first time this thing's had power to the wheels in 50 years or more. We got some carburetor tuning or some ignition problems, but so far the drive shaft is spinning nice, not a whole lot of vibration, if any. And of course the tire's never been balanced or anything like that, but the rear end is not making any heat, just sitting there idling in third gear. And engine oil pressure is looking decent, and so is the water temp. All right, what we did was we changed the distributor out because it would not take any fuel at all and it would backfire, so I was thinking maybe an ignition problem. That distributor was a swap meet distributor. I put the one that came with this motor back in, and let's listen to it now. See if you guys notice the difference. You can control everything, yep.
You can control everything, yep.
We're just going to do a quick check, make sure that the safety switch will kill the whole car, even with the ignition on. So.
Give it about a couple thousand RPM.
All right, that passes the safety check. All right, so it's behaving pretty well. The carburetor still definitely needs some work. That's whatever carburetor came on the engine when we bought it. Remember, we only bought this engine for a mock-up. We had no idea what kind of condition it was in. So I'm thinking we ought to put this thing on the ground and see if it'll move under its own power. Ignition on, power on. Stick that bolt in the in your pocket. All right, contact.
Yep, I'm clear. Sweet. Fuel is off.
Thanks.
So I got a video of it driving down down the road with your phone too.
Good.
So.
Well, that was a success.
Yeah.
Happy Easter, everybody.
folks, I hope you enjoyed this one. Obviously, this is a super significant day, being Easter Sunday. Christ is risen, and as much as my neighbors probably didn't appreciate it, I chose to bring the old number 7. As you all know, we call it the B&J Special, named after my mom and Roger's wife. Anyway, to bring it to life. So I have to say, I'm super excited. The thing starts and runs pretty well. The carburetor is iffy, but it still works. As you saw, we ran into a problem with what I thought was going to be a great distributor, ended up being not good at all, and something was going on. Wherever we were asking for our RPM, the spark would literally shut off. So I put the old distributor back in that came with the motor, and the thing came right to life. So took it for a ride up and down the street. Hopefully you enjoyed the footage of that, and got some great pictures of it. Super excited. We have some car shows coming up real soon, and it needed to have that shakedown. I needed to make sure all the systems work. The cooling system seems to be behaving. The oil pressure is actually surprisingly okay, and the brakes just need some adjusting. That was the first time that they had really any kind of test to see if it stopped the wheels. They definitely work. It just takes a pump, maybe two, to really get them to lock right down. So a little bit of carburetor work. It really needs a good competition series Holley carburetor. But for now, I'm actually really impressed with the motor. It pulls hard. The transmission seems great. The rear end isn't making any strange noises. You know, we drove it around the yard, drove it up and down the street, and the temperature of the rear end was still whatever the temperature is outside. It was like 55 today, so when you put your hand on the rear end, it actually felt cool. So I'm really, really excited. There's no leaks, so nothing but more good stuff to come. Hope you enjoy it. Happy Easter. We'll see you in the next video.